वेलकम टू सर मेरा लेट अस टॉक अबाउट मेजरमेंट ऑफ डिस्टेंस बाय चेनिंग एंड ब्रिजिंग देयर आर द वेरियस इक्विपमेंट टू बी यूज्ड फॉर द चेन सर्वेइंग दैट इज चेन एरो टेप रिंजिंग रोड ऑफसेट रोड प्लंबो पैक लाइन एंगल द पर्पस ऑफ चेन सर्वेइंग टू डिटरमाइन द डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम स्टार्टिंग टू द एंड पॉइंट with the help of chain and tape is known as a chain survey. In this lecture, there are the two person are applicable. First one is the leader and second one is the follower. Leader is standing at the point of forward end of the chain and follower can be standing at the point of rear end of the chain and to establish the intermediate point on the ground. Now we have to go to know about the equipment to be used in chain surveying. First one is chain. There are the four types of the chain: engineering chain, girder chain, metric chain, revenue chain. First one is engineering chain. The total length of engineering chain is 100 feet and 1 inch equal to 1 feet. Second is girder chain. The total length of girder chain is 66 feet and 1 inch equal to 0.6. Metric chain, the total length of the metric chain is 20 meter or 30 meter. In 20 meter, there are 100 links or 30 meter, there are 150 links. This is a brass handle which is attached on both end of the chain and the width is 70 mm and the center to center distance between the two rings is called one link length. The total length of link is 200 mm or 20 cm. This type of brass ring is attached at every 1 meter length. This type of tally is attached at every 5 meter length. This type of tally is attached at every 10 meter length. This type of tally is attached at every 50 meter length. Fourth one is revenue chain. The total length of the revenue chain is 33 feet and there are 16 links. Next equipment is ranging rod. The total length of ranging rod is 3 meter and it can be divided into a number of strips, red or orange. Second strip is white. Third is red or orange, fourth one is white. On bottom side, it is tapered and next is peg. It can be made from the timber and the cross section size is 25 mm into 25 mm and the height is 150 mm. The purpose of peg is to mark the station point on the ground. Next is arrow. The length of the arrow is 400 mm and the diameter of the circle is 50 mm and the diameter of the rod is 4 mm. How to take the field observation on the ground? First you have marked the ground station point with the help of arrows and name is A, B, and C. After that, you can remove the arrows from the point of A, B, and C and drill the ranging rod into the given points. And all the ranging rods should be in range with the help of the leader or follower. After that, you can measure the distance from A to B. That is L1 and B to C, that is L2.
We are taking a field observation on the ground. First you have marked the ground station point with the help of ranging rod. This is a first ranging rod that is named by A. Second rod is named by B and third ranging rod named by C. There are the two persons at the field. One person are standing at this point that is known as a leader and second person is standing at the point of rear end at C point, that is known as a follower. After that, you can check the all the ranging roads are in range or not. If the ranging roads are not in range, you can use the line ranger or the hand signals. After that, after ranging the roads in a straight line, you can measure the distance from A to B point and B to C point with the help of chain. When we have to measure the distance from A to C point, unfold the chain and one handle is touched with the first ranging road and other end is touched with the third ranging road, that will be the C point. Then you can count the length after measuring the distance from A to B and B to C. We have to calculate it with the help of counting the lengths. The distance from A to B is 7.400 meter and B to C distance is 5.600 meter. You can add up the distance A, B and B, C. 7.400 plus 5.600 is equal to the value of 13 meters. The distance, total distance from A to C is 13 meters.